On October 25th of 2022, a major and worrying change was detected at the Semeru volcano in Indonesia. Rapid uplift began at the volcano's summit, indicating the influx of a new and large batch of magma. This has accelerated since October 28th, and since then, the volcano has been pushed upwards by a rate of approximately 2 centimeters or 4/5 of an inch each day. Then, at 2:40 p.m. local time on the same day, sensors began recording a continuous harmonic tremor, which is generally caused by the rapid movement of magma and volcanic gases, often preceding a volcanic eruption. As of the writing of this video, this harmonic tremor is still ongoing more than 30 hours later. All of this unrest is pointing towards a likely but not certain conclusion. The Semeru volcano is potentially on the verge of producing a large explosive eruption. As a result, the local geological agency, PVMBG, has declared the following areas off-limits. In a circular radius around Semeru's summit, a 5-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions. This expands to 13 kilometers in Semeru's southeastern sector and expands further to 17 kilometers along its Pacific River, where you are not to go within 500 meters of the river channel. These areas could be hit with pyroclastic flows that incinerate everything they touch, lahars, ashfall, and other volcanic hazards. You might recall that Semeru's last major eruption occurred in December of 2021 when an unstable lava dome collapsed, creating a 15-kilometer or 50,000-foot-high eruption column and sending superheated pyroclastic flows more than 13 kilometers to the southeast, destroying a local bridge. Due to the current topography of Semeru's summit crater, which is breached to the southeast, pyroclastic flows are most likely to travel the furthest distances in that direction. However, this is not necessarily a guarantee, as other drainages could also be affected. However, although a large paroxysm is not a certainty, if one was to occur, it would likely be larger than Semeru's 2021 eruption, but smaller than Merapi's 2010 eruption. A good comparison to what might occur is Merapi's 1961 VEI-3 explosive eruption. Although the area outlined in red represents the most likely regions which could experience volcanic hazards from a paroxysm, I am not confident that the stated radius is sufficient. Thus, I have created two unofficial extended danger zones which could experience volcanic hazards marked as orange for higher threat and yellow for lower threat. If this deformation continues at such a high rate and gas emissions also increase, then a paroxysm will become more and more likely. After Semeru's lava dome is pushed further and further outwards, it might explode, resulting in either the partial or complete destruction of the lava dome. This powerful volcanion, or in a worst-case scenario, subplanean eruption, would then create pyroclastic flows, a towering ash cloud, and eject boulders of rock down the slope. If you live adjacent to Semeru and within the area I have mapped, I recommend getting out if you can, and if you cannot, be prepared in case large evacuation notices are issued. As a final note, this dramatic uplift and volcanic tremor could just unexpectedly end without a new eruption. However, it is generally good policy to prepare for the worst but hope for the best. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new YouTube member Zed for supporting this channel.